Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in this video, I'm going to talk about open bonds and closed bonds in your medic space. So let's get started. Let me begin with the definition of an open bond in your medic space. Let X be a medic space with a medic D. And in X, given any two elements X and Y, we can measure the distance between X and Y using the metric D. So we can define the notion of an open bond similarly to the way we define an open bond in the Euclidean space Rn. Given any element C in X and any positive real number R, the open bond centered at C with radius R is the set BCR consisting of all X in X such that the distance between C and X is strictly less than R. As you're going to see later on, an open bond in your metric space may not have the circular shape like this. We use this figure just for the purpose of illustration. So here is the center of the bond, and here is the radius R. The open bond with center at C and radius R consists of all points X in X, such that the distance between X and C, or C and X, it doesn't matter, is strictly less than R. In the next examples, I'm going to talk about some examples of open bonds in different metric spaces. The first example is very familiar. We consider X equals R2, and on X, we consider the Euclidean distance given by this formula. Okay, the center in this situation is the origin in R2, and the radius is 1. Then we obtain the following representation for the open bond with the center at C and radius 1. This is the set of all points with components x1, x2 in R2 such that x1 squared plus x2 squared is strictly less than 1. How can you obtain this representation? It is very simple because if X has two components x1, x2 and C is 0, 0, then the distance between C and X is nothing but the square root of x1 squared plus x2 squared. Then setting the square root of x1 squared plus x2 squared less than 1 and square both the sides of the inequality, we obtain this inequality. Okay, and here's the illustration for the open bond with center at C and radius R in this example. In the second example, we consider the same set X. However, in this situation, D1, we consider D1 the Manhattan distance in R2, given by this formula. Okay, so again, we consider the same center and the same radius R as in the previous example. In this metric space, however, BCR has this representation. It is the set of all x1, x2 in R2 such that the absolute value of x1 plus the absolute value of x2 is less than 1. And again, to obtain this formula, this representation, it is very simple because the distance between this point to C is nothing but the absolute value of x1 plus the absolute value of x2 based on this formula for D1. Okay. Now, the open bond with center at C and radius R in this situation has the diamond shape like this. To draw this figure, we only need to consider different cases for x1 and x2. Say, if x1 is greater than or equal to 0 and x2 is greater than or equal to 0, this inequality becomes x1 plus x2 less than 1. And it is very easy to draw that figure in R2 based on the line x1 plus x2 is equals 1. Okay, in the third example, we consider X equals R2 again. However, the matrix in this situation is the infinity distance given by this formula. Okay, this is not hard to obtain the following representation for the open ball with center that C and data are. And if you know about the Cartesian products, then you will see that the open ball with center that C and data are in this situation is the Cartesian product of the open interval from minus 1 to 1 with itself. And in this example, the open ball with center that C and data are is a square. Okay. It is very interesting that we consider the same set X, but on X we consider different matrix, and therefore we have different matrix spaces. Then we obtain different representations for the open balls with center at C and radius R in those matrix spaces. The next example is a little bit more involved. We consider the set C0, 1 consisting of all continuous functions defined on the closed bounded interval from 0 to 1, and the distance in this matrix space is the max distance, okay? And to know more about this matrix space, please see the description below, okay? In this example, let g be the 0 function. What it means here is g of x is 0 for all x in this interval. So this blue line is the graph of the function on this interval. And we set the radius b1, okay? In this situation, the open ball with center at g and radius r is the set of all functions in C01 such that the function values lie strictly in between minus 1 and 1. To obtain this representation, you need to use the definition of an open ball in a matrix space. We need to know how to compute the distance between the 0 function and f. Okay, is the max of the absolute value of f of x, because g of x is 0, for x in the interval from 0 to 1. And you need to know about the extreme value theorem as well. Okay, so this figure illustrates the open ball with center at g and radius r. In this example, any function whose graph lies strictly in between minus 1 and 1 belongs to this open ball, okay? The next example is about an arbitrary set X with the discrete matrix. And again, to know more about this matrix space, please look at the link in the description below, okay? So DAB is 0 if A is equal to B and 1 otherwise. In this matrix space, we take any C in X and any radius R greater than 0, then we obtain this representation for the open ball for with center at C and radius R. It depends on the radius. If the radius R is less than or equal to 1, then this open ball is just a single point set, that is the center of the ball. In the case where the radius is strictly greater than 1, the open ball with center at C and radius R is the entire space X. How can you obtain this representation? Let's look at one example where R is equal to 1/2, okay? Then BCR consisting of all X in X such that DCX is strictly less than 1/2. And because DCX is strictly less than 1/2, there is only one possibility, that is X is equal to C. Okay, and if X is equal to C, then DCX is 0 is strictly less than 1/2. Therefore, the open ball with center at C and radius R in that situation is just the center of the ball. Okay, it is similar for all the cases of R. Okay, now if R is greater than 1, say if R is 2, how can you find this ball? We are looking at all X in X such that the distance between C and X is strictly less than 2. But no matter what X you take, the distance between X and C is either 0 or 1, so it's strictly less than 2. Therefore, any X in X belongs to this ball. Okay? The reverse inclusion is obvious because the open ball is always a subset of X, and therefore In that situation, BC are the open ball center that CN data size the entire space X. Okay, you can prove that this ball is X if R is any real number that is greater than 1. Finally, I'm going to talk about the definition of a closed ball in a metric space. It is very similar to the case of an open ball. In this metric space, we take any C in X and any positive real number R. Then the closed ball with center at C and data size the set of all X in X such that the distance between C and X is less than or equal to R. So we only need to replace the strict inequality in the definition of an open ball by this less than or equal to inequality. Later on, I'm going to talk about open sets and closed sets in a metric space, and you're going to see that any open ball is an open set and any closed ball is a closed set. So open balls are examples of open sets in a metric space, and closed balls are examples of closed set in a metric space. So let's see that in my future videos. This completes my video on open ball and closed balls in your metric space. Thank you for watching.